Hello, this is Adolf. Welcome to the video lecture series on the course of building construction. Unit number 1 and unit number 2 are already covered in the previous videos. So by this video, we are going to start our unit number 3, that is construction of superstructure. The content of this video lecture is, we are going to see about stone masonry. And what are the terms related to stone masonry? What is uncoursed rubble stone masonry and coursed rubble stone masonry? Before we are going to see about stone masonry, we have to know about what is masonry. Masonry is defined as the art of construction. So it is a combination of some building units such as clay bricks, sand, lime brick, precast, hollow concrete block, concrete slab, glass brick. So these are the some of the building units. So masonry is a construction of combination of some building units that are arranged systematically and bonded together to form a homogeneous mass. So why we have to form as a homogeneous mass is, then only they can withstand to other loads and transmit them through the mass without fail or disintegration. So what are the classification of masonry? We have stone masonry, brick masonry, hollow block concrete masonry, reinforced masonry and composite masonry. So let's start with stone masonry. So stone masonry is, if you are constructing any structure with the help of stone that are bonded together with the mortar, we will call it as a stone masonry. So where we will go the stone masonry is, the stones are available in abundance in nature. So if you are having a stone that is naturally available more abundantly, the stone is available abundantly in nature, so then we will go with the stone masonry. So by cutting and dressing to the proper shape, they can provide to a construction of various building components such as walls, columns, footings, arches, lintels, beams. So these are the some various building components. So by proper cutting and proper dressing to the shape, we can provide the stones for the various building components. So what are the uses of stone masonry? So these stone masonries are used on building foundation, dams and monumental structures. So best example of the stone masonry is Taj Mahal. So it is built full and fully stone. That stone is marble. So monumental structure, we use stone masonry. Or building walls, piers, columns, pillars, lighthouses and architectural work, we will go with this stone masonry. Some of the arches, this is a dome or lintel or beam, roof, floors, paving job, even railway ballast, we will use the stone masonry. These are the uses of the stone masonry. So what are the terms that are related to the stone masonry? The first one is facing. So facing is the exterior of the wall exposed to weather is known as face. The material used in the facing of wall is known as facing. So this is the brick we are going to use. if this side is exposed to weather, then this side is the face of the stone. So if it is this side is faced to the weather, then this will be face. Okay, so the side which is exposed to weather, we will call it as the face, or that the exterior of the wall. So then what is the interior of the wall? So interior of the wall, it does not expose to weather, so that we will call it as a back. So backing is the inner surface of the wall not exposed to weather is called as backing. The material forming back is known as backing. Third one is hotting. So it is the interior portion of the wall between facing and backing. So this is your facing, this is your backing. So between these two, facing and backing, we will have hotting. So hotting is, it is the interior portion of a wall between facing and backing. Fourth one is through stones. So these through stones are, these stones are interlock the position in between facing and backing of the wall. So this backing and facing, these stones, through stones will use to interlock the portion between facing and backing. So like this arrangement of stones, we will interlock the gaps between them. So some stones in one piece or two piece are placed at regular interval across the wall. So sometime it will be two piece or a single piece. So this is called through stones. Fifth one is cornerstone. Cornerstone is a stone at the center of a wall uniting two intersecting walls. So see here, this is one wall, this is another wall. So these two walls are united by an intersecting cornerstone. So here also it is a cornerstone. So cornerstone will be provided. So in this diagram also, this is wall number one, this is wall number two, it is connected by a cornerstone. So cuons is called as cornerstones. So this cornerstones is also called as cuons. The next topic is uncoursed rubble masonry. And this is one type of a rubble masonry. These uncoursed rubble masonry are cheapest, roughest and poorest form of stone masonry. It's as shown in the diagram. See, the stones are in different shape and size. They are not in uniform shape and size. So in the uncoursed rubble masonry, the shape and sizes of the stones are very much vary, and it is directly obtained from quarry. So no dressing will be done in this uncoursed rubble masonry. So this diagram, see the diagram, it is like some random manner all the shapes and size of the stones are laid and to form a course by using mortar. It is not in any particular way. So all these shapes of stones are used to form the courses. See here we have small stones and we have large stones. So no particular arrangement. So randomly we use all the sizes, all the shapes and sizes of the stone to form the course. So in this uncoursed rubble masonry, the mason will roughly trim and shape the stone by knocking off protruding edges. So he will trim and shape the stone. The larger stones are used at jambs and corners, jambs and corners to increase the strength. So if it is a large stone, we will use in jamb or corner to increase the strength. The suitability of this uncoursed rubble masonry is, these type of stone masonries are used in constructing a building, godowns, boundary walls. We can see these type of uncoursed rubble masonry. This uncoursed rubble masonry are of two types. One is uncoursed random rubble masonry and uncoursed square rubble masonry. So uncoursed random rubble masonry. So uncoursed random rubble, that means the stones are in any particular shape or size, any shape, any size we will use in this uncoursed random rubble masonry. See in the diagram. So here no random size or shape, in any shape and size we will use, that is in the uncoursed random rubble masonry. But the weak corners and edges are removed with mason amber. So if a stone having weak corner or edges, weak edges, it will be removed with the help of mason's hammer. And the biggest stones are employed so at corners and jambs to increase the strength of masonry. See in this. So here it is a cornerstone or quoins. So bigger stones will be provided at the cornerstone or quoins, so to increase the strength of masonry. Next is uncoursed square rubble masonry. See here. So in the uncoursed square rubble, so in the diagram, all the stones will be in square shape, but not in same size. But it will be in same shape, but not in same size. So stone blocks are made roughly square with hammer. So roughly we square them with hammer. Generally, the facing stones are given hammer dressed finish. So the facing stones will have hammer dress. See here, this diagram, every stones will have some. So in the facing we will have some hammer dressed finish. Same as the previous uncoursed random rubble, in the uncoursed square rubble also we will use large stone at quoins. So large stone at quoins will be used. So this is the uncoursed square rubble masonry. Coursed rubble masonry. This is the second method in the second type in the rubble masonry. So this is the second type in the rubble masonry. So as shown in the diagram, so all the stones are equally dressed in size as well as mostly in size as in shape. So this is an alternative ways. See here, this is and these are in equal size, this one and this one in equal size. So stones have equal size and equal shape. So the coursed random rubble masonry, in which the face stone are squared on all joints, stone squared on all joint and bedded by hammer or chisel dressing before laying them in course. So the stones we are getting from the quarry, before we are laying them in the course, we have to do hammer dressing or a chisel dressing, and we have to square all the joints on the faces. So then only we will lay the stone in the course bed. These type of coursed rubble masonry is superior than any other type of rubble masonry. The stone to be laid in course should be of equal sizes. Equal sizes. The joints are roughly uniform and broken vertical. Depend upon the dressing and finishing of the stone, the coursed rubble masonry is further divided into first class, second class, and third class coarse rubble masonry. So what are the suitability? The coarse rubble masonry mostly used for residential public building, hospitals, markets, modern residential building and apartments. So this is where we use the coarse rubble masonry. So in this video we cover the topics such as masonry and what is a stone masonry, what are the terms related to the stone masonry. Then we saw about uncoarsed random rubble masonry and coarsed rubble masonry. So in the upcoming video lectures we see about the other topics in the stone masonry. Thank you.